Formerly suicidal Redditors, what's something that kept you alive a little while longer and helped you to get through the dark times in your lives? Ending of One Piece. In May of 2019, I overdosed on pills intentionally. I was found by my sister, who called the ambulance, and a day and a half later I woke up in a detox facility. Eventually my parents picked me up and everything changed from that moment on. Something was triggered in me that made me realize dying would not actually stop my pain. Dying, especially committing suicide, would only pass on my pain to those who loved me. I have two children, and it became clear that if I had died that night, I would have infected them with my depression. I would have infected them with my trauma. The only thing I could do to stop the pain from infecting anyone else was to heal. That's what I did. It's been a year and a half, and I've dealt with parts of my pain I never thought I could. I'm happier and more me now than I ever was. I still am. It'll sound really fucking dumb, but the only thing that keeps me alive at this point is the excitement of new games coming out and the PS5. My dog and mom, they both would be sad if I did. This is gonna get buried, but my mom. Most amazing woman ever. I love her. My cats. When I reached my lowest, they kept me going and waking up every day. If I didn't have them, I would have given up, most definitely. Honestly, it was my cat and wife. My cat, Brownie, was my best friend, and I had him since he was born. My wife loves me and cares so much that she came to see me at every visitor time when I was in the BSU. Those two were what kept me going, because I didn't want to let them down and leave them. Friends. Music. I had my hand on the gun, and my friend texted me to help with HW. The feeling that someone needed me kept me from pulling the trigger. I was 13 and my mother was suicidal. Long, long story with multiple attempts, cutting / self-harm, 72-hour holds and hospitalizations, etc. Over the years. One long talk with her, I promised her, "Where you go, I go." And that if she killed herself, I would follow. And as I suffer from bipolar 2 and anxiety, I also promised if she never killed herself, I would not either. Years later, when I was 18 and she had passed from health/heart complications unrelated to depression, I had a talk with my dad and he brought that up. He told me I likely saved her life multiple times from what my mom had told him. She had wanted to plenty of times off and on. But my words stuck with her, and she told my dad that I was too smart, and no matter how she would think to kill herself and make it look like she didn't, I would find out, and she took me at my word. Her dying of natural causes and that conversation/promise ingrained in my mind has been what has kept me alive several times over my 41 years on this rock. No matter how dark it has got or gets in the future, I will keep my word. Suicide is just never on the table for me. Even being an atheist and knowing she isn't watching or waiting. Keeping my word to my mom/best friend growing up had not only saved her life back then, but mine as well. Had a horribly abusive stepfather. Planned to kill myself on Christmas morning to completely ruin the day for everyone else in my family who stood by and watched as he did it. 2 weeks before Christmas, I went to a concert. I got there by myself, got the tickets, had a blast, and got home by myself. I realized that there was a life to live, I just had to get it for myself. A year and a half later, I moved overseas and never went back to that house. He is alone and miserable now. I attempted when I was 17. Sent to an outpatient daily therapy for 6 weeks. We had an exercise where we wrote out numbers 1 to 80 on a long piece of paper roll. Then we had to fill in some of our memories next to the number of the year it happened. When you held up the paper and see how small of a blip my teenage years were to the whole picture, it made me realize that I would miss out on so much if I ended my story too soon. That things are shitty sometimes, but they are really good sometimes. That happiness isn't a destination, it's an emotion, you merely get the opportunity to pass through it. Also, if you are focused so much how shitty you feel or unhappy you are, you miss opportunities of actually being happy. I had a physics teacher in high school tell us if we were suicidal to wait until morning. Try to get some sleep. There have been studies done that show that most suicides happen during dark hours. Don't come at me. I don't have any links, but does it really matter if it's proven or not? A fresh day really helped. Sometimes I still say I just need a new day. It was my parents for me. I knew it would destroy them and I couldn't do that to them. When I was at the brink, I decided to have a nap first, and if I woke up and still felt the same, I was going to do it. When I woke up an hour later, my mum was sitting on my bed. I hadn't eaten all day. She had made me a fruit smoothie. She then got me out of bed, helped me shower, and sat me in front of the TV to watch our favorite show together. I had my head on her lap, and that's when I realized I couldn't do it. She saved my life that day. I owe it to her. As silly as it is, my main reason was my cat. Knowing it would have been a while until I was found, I worried about my cat going days without food and water. Knowing she wouldn't understand and miss me hurt me more than anything, so I pushed on and ended up getting the help I needed. I kept telling myself that without bad times in life, we wouldn't appreciate the good times. I was also pretty scared to die. I was too scared to use a knife, so I used a tiny, sharp screwdriver. I think this helped because instead of instantly breaking skin, I'd have to cut at the same spot for a while until blood would come out. Doing that multiple times over and over made me believe dying would be very painful. Thankfully, my family is healthy and we have very few pills/medication that are lethal. My kids. The thought that they would be without a mom like I was killed me. So I faked it till I made it. I made it. I realized I wasn't alone and others have felt that way. My suicidal ideations made me feel like I wasn't special or unique or going to be missed, but if others got through it, so could I. It helps to think that even strangers can know your pain, and the collective strength of trauma is a lifeline. Was hospitalized for an overdose at 15. Told all of my friends goodbye, all that jazz. I laid in my bed to wait for it to hit me when I realized real damn quick that I'd be abandoning all of my pets, who'd be stuck with my wildly irresponsible and abusive father and a grandmother that would have no idea how to care for them. I've never jumped out of a bed so quickly in my life. Immediately told my grandma, in the middle of sobbing my eyes out, that I needed to go to the hospital. Haven't tried it again since then. My pets kept me going till I could escape my terrible home life and get myself back on track. Spite. In all seriousness, not much other than the fact that I'm evidently terrible at tying knots. Only further comment on that is that over the course of 6 times and severe trauma, I can confidently say I won't be trying that a single more time. Suicide is a permanent solution to a temporary problem. That sentence will keep going in my mind like a merry-go-round, when I'm feeling really bad. Kinda dumb, cause my depression has almost been the constant thing since I was 7 years old, so not really a temporary thing. And as other people have said, hurting my family. A number of things, though largely, fear. A fear that I will devastate my loved ones. A fear that there is nothing after this. A fear that there is. A fear that tomorrow could be better. A fear that I was so close to being happy. Always fear. My 2 dogs. I knew if they didn't have me around, my family wouldn't take care of them, and the thought of them not having a house or food made it worth for me to stay alive. Weird, but when I've felt super depressive, I tell myself after this project, usually crochet, so it takes a while, more than a few hours or sometimes even days or weeks. Then after the next one. Now I look forward to it so much and it's very cathartic. Makes me calm and centered, and I can think and relax and just be happy. Just yarn browsing makes me so happy. This is going to be super basic and probably a very common one, but the reason is my animals. They're super protective of me and don't really like other people unless I'm with them, so if I left them, they would probably only be brought to a shelter or put down, and that breaks my heart to think about. So yeah, I make sure to treat each day better, if only to make sure my pets are given the bed life they can get. I'm probably gonna get downvoted for this, but interestingly enough, my newfound religion and faith in God. Who'da thunk it? Knowing that while suicide would end my misery, it would just pass that misery on to my wife, kids and parents. Failing. My girlfriend who never left my side. I didn't want it to leave her alone. Just thinking about my sister and how much it would affect her losing our dad and then me. Literally one sentence, suicide doesn't stop the pain, it just gives it to someone else.